We live in Long Beach and love all the diversity and culture the city has to offer. Recently, the New York Post ranked Long Beach number 4 on its list, the best places to live in the U.S. There are many colorful parades and festivals. Great local restaurants, neighborhood coffee shops, and unique stores. An extensive bike path system that goes along the beach and throughout the city. Also, we get out to enjoy nature at all the parks and beaches. And we like to find community activities in the Long Beach and LA area that are inexpensive or free.
Come along as we explore the city. This is our urban adventure. Our first segment, we go to the farmer's market. There you can get fruits and vegetables straight from the farm. Also a great way to connect with friends and neighbors.
In the next segment, we explore the Long Beach bike path system. We stop to visit some cool bike shops and ride along with the Cyclone Coasters, a vintage bike group. Finally, we go to the Day of the Dead Festival at MOLA, where there was Sugar Skull face painting, performances by the LA Opera, plus amazing art and vendors.
This is our urban adventure.
Hi, we're here at the Long Beach Marina Farmers Market.
There are many farmers markets all over the city. If you want fresh produce, it's the place to go.
The vendors are always helpful and give us great tips and information. First, we stop to talk with Justin from the Seeds of Zanzidu.
So how did you get into growing these, though?
Microgreens. Microgreens are kind of like my gateway crop. So I've always just wanted to be in farming and sustainable agriculture and stuff like that. So I decided I'll start here because I didn't have a lot of space.
Smart.
And this taught me a lot. So right here you have a pea shoot. Right here, these are nice tall guys. Right here, these are daikon radish, really spicy, probably the spiciest one that we carry. Then these are the fan favorites of the market, and these are the sunflower shoots.
So what do you think is the advantage of sprouted versus just having regular greens?
Well, these guys right here, these aren't just sprout, these are microgreens. So microgreens, actually, the lady that just probably gave the best example on a sprout is more like an infant, where a microgreen is more like a baby. So you guys, we're actually getting the greens on this right now. Now, the biggest advantage to these, one, the flavor. That's going to be the first thing that stands out most people. And then the health benefits.
Yeah.
So these guys, it's said for the most part that it's 4 to 40 times more nutrient rich.
A huge bag of this.
We're going to be so healthy this week.
More than market mixes in there too. Those guys have everything here and more.
Thank you.
Besides produce, there are local vendors selling gourmet products and handmade goods. You can also stop and have lunch from one of the many food stands. Next, we stopped at Scone Age Bakery.
Specialty are our scones. So most popular has strawberries, raspberries, and blueberries in it. And all our products are oatmeal based. So we have granola, we have unsweetened options available, and gluten-free, which are the organic, and then we have granola bars.
How long have you worked for the bakery?
Oh, well, my dad owns it.
Oh, so, okay.
Yes.
So you've grown up with these?
Uh-huh.
I'll take one of these.
Okay, $4, okay. Please.
How long have you guys been in business?
Well, this bakery we opened in 2000. Before this, we had a little cafe on the peninsula. Called Cafe Con Leche. We've been making this stuff for like 25 years.
Okay,
thanks.
So how much are they?
$4.
$4.
Thank you.
Have you tried this pomegranate? No. You're not gonna find it anywhere else.
You guys grow it?
Yeah, it's really, really sweet.
It's like a lot lighter.
Yeah, it's like really sweet, and the seeds are way more chewable.
He said that these were really, really sweet and have a better taste. So right, these are delicious.
So good.
Try a bite.
Very delicious.
Okay, thank you.
You can fry it and put some eggs in it, like bitter it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Sounds good.
Yeah, they're really cool looking. Ooh, eggplant. Nice.
Avocados.
They look good.
Oh yeah, I look delicious.
We should go and let's get those. Wow, they're so beautiful.
Put it on the table and I'll talk to you in four. I brought this lonely mansion on my recent broken home. And tonight I'm sitting alone, digging up bones. I'm digging up bones. I'm digging up bones. So many things that are better left than alone. I'm resurrecting memories of a love that's dead and gone. And tonight I'm sitting alone.
Heirloom tomatoes are my favorite, so we're always looking for the best heirloom tomatoes. This place has so many varieties. Yay! Let's get that one. What do you think? Many farmers markets in Long Beach. This is the one by our house at Bixby Park, and it's so convenient because it's right across the street.
What did you try?
Royal grapes and princess grapes and red scarlet seedless grapes. They are one of the yummiest.
Yay!
At first we came here for healthy produce, but the farmer's market has turned into much more. A wonderful place to make friends and meet people who inspire us.
To have a nucleus
but you would cut this so you could, that's the bigger part.
Right.
To save that, we've got the nucleus. That's the old man of Peru.
Okay.
And this is the old woman of Peru. We have the same hairstyle. except I gotta keep color in mind and keep that Rod Stewart look up, you know?
Hello, young lady. How are you?
You know, Sash, it's my wife, Alice.
Hi, Alice.
Whatever.
Well, don't worry. As soon as
the camera loves
as soon as we make 10 million, then we'll split it.
John spreads the word of positivity to everybody that comes to the farmer's market.
Oh, okay.
Okay, ready? Hit it.
The Optimist Creed, promise yourself to be so strong that nothing can disturb your peace of mind, to talk health, happiness, and prosperity to every person you meet.
Yes, and who has the best produce ever here?
Is it your question?
Long Beach currently has 139 miles of bike paths. There's an 8-to-80 strategy, meaning all people from 8 to 80 years old will feel comfortable using all the paths.
The city's new bike master plan adds hundreds of miles of bike paths in the coming years. The goal is for Long Beach to become the most bicycle-friendly city in the country,
which helps create access for everyone. New bike shops are popping up everywhere. We visited city grounds in the East Village and spoke to Marlon about what they offer.
Helping people out and fixing flats. And
yeah, I just saw you fix a flat, yeah. Really nice.
Just trying to get customers back on the road and not get hurt.
Do you find there's a lot more people coming in for service because of all the bike lanes here in
yeah.
Services, the city?
Services, just for stopping by just to look at products, what we have.
Okay, so single speed.
Yes.
And what was the second thing?
Single speed and track. So just like all these right here, all these are all single speed and track. This one's track specifically, so this one's fully fixed. So you get to go backwards and stuff, but it does come on brakes like this one too. There's other ones, like this one, the freewheel stuff. It's a single speed, but it's just only on one gear. It's like you're riding a road bike, but it's only just staying on one gear.
Right.
Really doing anything else but focusing on brakes and stuff.
Uh-huh.
What fixed gear feels like is, remember when you rode a tricycle with a pedal in the front wheel?
Yes.
It's the same exact thing. When you can go backwards and go a little forward.
Yeah. Right, it's that same feeling.
Yeah.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
That sounds cool.
Yeah, one of the first bikes that was invented was by Albert Einstein. You know, the actual fixed gear.
Right.
Yeah, that big front wheel bike. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Next, we went to the bicycle stand on Broadway, which is located in a cool 1923 firehouse building.
They specialize in repairing and restoring vintage bicycles.
Their staff is really knowledgeable and can help you out with any biking questions you might have.
Don't mind me.
Okay.
Just doing something really interesting, so I just wanted to film it. Make you a star. What are you doing?
I'm trying to run a new brake cable here.
Oh.
But it's all like it goes inside the handlebars.
Oh wow.
Can't find where it goes.
Oh, it's hard. Yeah, you push it in, it just comes out.
In 2006, two friends that loved vintage bikes started a group called the Cyclone Coasters. They meet the first Sunday of every month at Profolio Coffee House on Retro Row.
It draws vintage bike riders from all over Southern California.
This meetup is a fun social event where vintage enthusiasts can exchange information and show off their new rides. The founders, Drew and Bernard, are committed to an informal and friendly event, open to anyone interested in joining. After they finished gathering at Profolio, they took off for the first leg of their ride. Going down Juanaparo Avenue, towards the ocean, and ending up at Bixby Park.
This once a month ride draws between 150 to 200 vintage bike lovers.
They gather there to use the band shell, which is a great place for their announcements and upcoming events. Said goodbye to the Cyclone Coasters as they rode away down First Street on the final ride to Belmont Shore. Such a cool free event and a great way to meet the locals.
In our final segment, we went to MOLA, the Museum of Latin American Art.
At MOLA, every Sunday is free due to a grant from Target. We visited MOLA for their Dia de los Muertos festival to learn more about this fascinating holiday. Dia de los Muertos, or Day of the Dead, is November 1st and 2nd. It's a holiday dedicated to remembering deceased family members and loved ones. It celebrates their lives with food, drink, and parties. The symbols that appear everywhere at this time are skulls and skeletons, shown as sugar sweets, masks, and dolls. The event was on Sunday, so all the festivities and entertainment were free. Their galleries are filled with artwork by Latin American artists. There were so many entertaining performances throughout the day, starting with this beautiful Spanish dancing. Target had tables set up for sugar skull decorating and other crafts. And seeing the LA Opera perform free was wonderful. This singer performed from The Barber of Seville.
The Day of the Dead recognizes death as a natural part of life.
At this time of year, the dead join the living to share in the celebrations. Getting your face painted as a sugar skull mask is a fun part of this tradition. For a small fee, a professional sugar skull makeup artist could decorate your face. Some people were good enough to do their own face painting. The LA Opera also performed some songs from Carmen. lots of booths with colorful items and food. Also, sponsors tables where you could spin for prizes. Aztec dancers and drummers had beautiful costumes and painted faces.
Enjoyed our day at Mola, and we look forward to going again soon. Hi, we're Alice and Steve from Our Urban Adventure. Thank you for watching the show.
For more information about our show and Long Beach, go onto our website, oururbanadventure.com. Thanks for watching.